Good morning. Good to see you all here. This is the last member meeting for the Tech Club until October because we have our meetings from October to May. And because it is our last meeting, this is also when we have our election. The two positions that are open, as you read in the newsletter, hopefully, are that of president and treasurer. So before we have the election, is there anyone who would like to be a part of being a candidate for one of these positions? Don't all rush at once. Okay, Liz Perry has agreed to continue to be treasurer if nobody steps up to be a candidate. I have agreed to be president and continue that if no one steps up to that. So, but part of what, and Linda, well, we already have the treasurer and vice president in place. But part of me being president, of course, is having a wonderful team on the board, which is Larry Trier as the vice president and in charge of the tech team, which is not my strength. Linda is our secretary, Liz is the treasurer, and Tim is our all-around past president, director, and just about everything we need, Tim Walter. So I could not do this without them. And the tech team is also very valuable too. They're the ones that take care of the tech lab, setting things up. Just now they've replaced new printers, making sure there are supplies. So we could not do all that we do without the tech team. Another group of people that I would like to recognize are also the club members who are also residents of Sunflower, like Tom Shambo, our speaker today, Tom Howland, Marie Van Hoos, who have stepped up to give a presentation to the group because many of you actually have more technology than perhaps you know. So when we start up again in October, I would invite all of you to think about presenting on something that you do in technology. Maybe you have some games you like to play. Maybe there's some apps you really just want to recommend. And for some of you, I think maybe it's kind of like, I don't want to stand in front of a group and talk. I can do this because I was a school counselor for many years and learned how to do that very well. But what I would offer is that if you'd like to present, but you're not so sure about speaking, I also love to play out Oprah. So I can interview you about it. So you answer questions rather than giving a presentation. So if you have something that you do a lot in technology, let us know so we can include you because what you know may be something that's probably something someone else in the club would like to know. So we have the elections, we have that. Let's go to Larry for an update on the tech lab.
Well, in the tech lab, we do have a new printer in there, and I'm working on updating the manual for that. But it's very similar to the way the old printer that was there worked. The reason we replaced it was it was damaged, and it wouldn't even send faxes anymore or do any of that. So we ended up purchasing a new one. And it's a business quality printer, so it will last a long time. And if you have any questions about how to operate it, you can give any of the tech team a call or let the front desk know, and they can call us and we can come down and help you out with it. But like I said, it's not very complex. It's pretty easy to use. All the menu stuff is right there on the top, just like the old 9130 that was in there. And as far as anything else goes, the rest of the lab is still working the way it's always been working. We're just reducing the number of printers, so we reduce the number of toner, the amount of toner we have to keep on hand, and that type of thing. And the printers don't usually get used more than one at a time. So that's pretty much everything that's going on in the tech lab. One thing that it did. A gentleman came in today and brought in a couple of computers that he said, give them away, whatever you want to with them. So there's an HP over there, a PC, and there's a small Apple laptop over there. So if you want to use one of those, you're welcome to it. The Apple's in 2013. I don't know the age on the HP, but it's probably around that same time. So that's all I've got.
Thank you, Eric. And now for our speaker. How many of you are involved in the blog watch here at Fun Club? All right. Excellent. Tom Chambo is the head of the Black Watch. And maybe you'd also mention a little bit about that. He's here to talk about home security. And certainly here at Sunflower, I think many of us feel pretty safe here, but it's also good to make sure that we have the security we need. So with that, Tom Chambo, I think you have your mic.
I do. I got it. Yes.
So good morning. I'm Tom Chambo. I don't know if you know me or don't know me, but to give you a little hint, I started my career at 18 in the United States Air Force and military police. So I started out in law enforcement. When I got out of the military, I went into civilian law enforcement. I was a police officer, canine handler in both of those organizations. And my career has been around security, either based on computer security or private security, one of those two elements. So I'm gonna talk about a little bit about both of those. I'm just gonna hark back to BlockWatch for a minute because somebody brought up, where'd you go there? The lights on our house, the garage lights that flash, there's a purpose for those, if you don't know that. If you need an ambulance, you need a fire truck, you need the police, if you'll turn those lights on, they'll know right where to go. So that's what they're not there to get your neighbor to come over so he knows where you live, or to chase the bats away. They do have a purpose. So I did want to mention that before we moved on. So I spent my career in law enforcement. When I got in about 1992 or 93, I went to Ernst & Young and did all their IT security, but I also was asked to take over physical security. And that's the first time I got acquainted with video cameras and the purpose of video cameras and security. But in the day, it would actually capture about every 30th frame of the camera. So we would put up cameras on all the doorways and in wide open office spaces. So we had laptops that were $7,000 a piece. They'd get up and walk out once in a while. So this was a way for us to protect our assets. Well, I went back, I had a stolen laptop, went back to the video. I brought it up, I saw a door open. I saw a hand reach onto the laptop and I saw the door closed. I didn't see another thing. So it didn't do us a lot of good back in those days. Since then, cameras have gotten not only a lot better, and I'm gonna demonstrate them today, but the quality of sound and video that you obtain, the cost of video, I have cameras on my house right now that cost $20 a piece, and you'll see how good the quality of film is. I have cameras that are set up on electricity, they're plugged in. I have cameras that are set up with solar. They all work very well. None of them are better or worse than anything else. So the purpose of the security, going back to 2014, I ran for the board of directors. And prior to that, there were two residents here, one that had their driveway painted and another one that had their house splashed with purple paint. And I thought, if I'm going to get on the board, and because of my history in video cameras and security, I'm going to put video cameras on my house. So I did that, and I'm going to show them to you now. So this is the front view. This is live off the side of my house. So I can see, as you can see, a pretty wide open area. Keep going down the screen. I'll get a wider view there for you. So you can see a pretty wide area. Somebody pulls in my driveway, somebody's out in the street. I have all that video. When I first put these cameras up,
probably the most time spent was looking at javelinas, coyotes, that kind of thing. But I have captured vehicles going by. I don't know if anybody ever knew Tim Meenan.
Yeah.
Tim Meenan. Tim went to the Home Depot one time, bought a bunch of landscaping material, came home, put it in his driveway, and then went to bed. Next morning, he attempted to put it up in his yard. When he got up, there were none of it there, was there. So I went back to my camera. I have a DVR that captures 6 months worth of video. And I just scoured through. You can see that vehicles going beyond there. So I captured that. I'm able to download it to a USB. And I cut it. And I, this is the bad thing about using your phone. I'll get a phone call here pretty soon, probably. But I was able to capture that video of cars going down our street at 3:30 and 4 o'clock in the morning. Now, you probably don't think about this, but we have young men and women that drive through our neighborhoods looking for cars parked in the driveway, looking for open doors, looking for houses that are empty. And it's a great opportunity for them because all of us sleep in the back of our houses. So you can have any kind of activity you want pretty much in the front, and nobody's going to see it. So I captured that video, and then I sent it out to the Marana PD. And I've done that on a couple of occasions. So it does come in very handy to help protect our neighbors. Then, get to the next one. I have 4 cameras. Here's the one on the other side of my house. So now I have both sides. If somebody tried to get between my house and the neighbor's house on either side, I would have be able to observe that. And in this particular camera, my neighbor lady was here in the garden working, and a coyote came up from behind her like he was stalking her. And she just happened to hear him walking in the gravel and turned around and jumped up and screamed at it, chased it off. And anybody need a cheap blood on sofa? And chased it off, and it would only go about 5-6 feet away from her and then come back. And so they have a camera on their house, but it didn't pick up that event. So Steve called me then and said, hey, your camera capture that. And then I sent him the copy of that video. So there are occasions where they do benefit. It's in my backyard, so I can see the whole activity in the back of my house. So it's just my back door. I've got the front door, the garage door, all protected by cameras. It's my kitchen. And I did the dishes this morning. So this is the door coming in from my garage. This door right here is my patio door over here. And if you came in my front door and tried to steal my TV, I would catch you. I'd get you on one of those areas. And I'm going to tell you a funny story about that camera. Anybody have an IQ on their garage that automatically opens your garage door or alerts you if it's open or closed, all that kind of stuff? So 3 o'clock one morning, my IQ goes off and alerts me that my garage door was open, which made me a little nervous. So I'm a former police officer, remember that, and I have a gun. So I get up and I walk out to my garage, look around, nothing there, the garage door is closed. So I come walking back in again, and I thought, you know, if somebody was hiding in my car or my garage or in my garbage can, I didn't check there. So I told my wife, I said, why don't you come out and stand here, and then I'll go back out, and if I find somebody, then I can yell or whatever. Not thinking about all that being captured on a video camera. Uh-huh. So I cut it out and I sent it to our kids and I said, this is what your mom and dad does at 3 a.m. walking around. Yes. So it, so that's a wired camera system. It's cabled into my house. It's caught on a DVR. That system cost me $169. I installed it. It was pretty easy to install. It's been up now for right at 10 years. I've never had a problem with it. So it's a good camera system, very secure. Today I looked up the price, it's $199. So it has come up a little bit. You can expand it. You can go from 4 cameras to 8, 16, all of that kind of stuff. But that's the one camera. Then I also have a wife's camera system. Now, Tim Meenan, after his event, went and put up a wife's camera. I'd never heard of him. Cost him $20, and he captured a group of javelinas tearing up his whole front yard one day. And he showed it to me, and I didn't think for $20 you were going to get much of a camera or that it was going to last very long. So I installed the first one up on the front of my garage, and it's been now right at 6 years, and it's still there, it's still working. So for $20, it's a pretty good camera. And the nice thing about both of these, as you can see, you can be at the Panama Canal and you go back to your house and look in the garage and see if your hot water heater's leaking or look at the front yard, whatever. And it's a real advantage to keep an eye on your house when you're gone.
What was the name of that?
Watts, W-Y-Z-E. And they have those that you plug in, those that are solar. Their solar panels for their cameras are like $19.95, really inexpensive. And I'll show you the one I have in my backyard. It's solar. So it's the same thing, $20 camera, it's running off of solar. And the reason I put it there is I have like floodlights on my back wall. And they're sensors, so anything that walks past them or near them sets off the sensor and a bright light comes on. Well, my bathroom window's right there, and that's my master bedroom. So at 3, 4 o'clock in the morning, all of a sudden, I get these bright lights in my bathroom window. And by the time I look out the window, I didn't see anything. So I decided to put a camera out there, see if I could find something. And I did. It was a big bunny rabbit, but at least I know what it was. My neighbor was having problems with feeders, bird feeders. And he asked me about cameras. So he put up a trail cam in his backyard. And he actually caught a big raccoon in his backyard, which I didn't even know we had in our neighborhood. So that's just literally that camera is sitting on a little plastic stool. It's not fastened to anything. And it hasn't fallen over. It hasn't blown away. So it works pretty good. And you can see for $20, it's a pretty good quality camera. I have a Ring doorbell. And the sun comes right in that doorway and hits my Ring doorbell. So if you come in and ring the doorbell, I can't see anything. All I can see is a shadow. So for $20 more, I put up this camera so I can see UPS or FedEx, whatever it is, mailman come up and I can actually get a visual of who's at my door. So it works pretty good. And the other thing about that particular view, and this is a good home security thought. If we're home in our house and somebody knocks on our front door, normally we go open it. And if you don't have a screen door, one of them steel doors, you're not exposed to whoever's standing outside you. And these people are pretty smart. So they'll send the young lady up to the door, knock on the door, and if there's a widow or a single person there, and they see this young lady out there, and she obviously must need help, so they open up the door. And then on either side of that doorway is a wall, and you can have four guys out there. And you wouldn't see one of them until you open the door and let them in. So having a camera there is kind of handy to see any activity that you have. So right next door to me on the other side is a lady's husband has dementia. She can't leave the house. She gets all of her groceries delivered. She gets her meals from DoorDash. She called me one day and she said, Tom, I see you have cameras on your house. Could you help me install one on my door so I can see people coming up to the house? So I did that. She's my age, and since I helped her install that first camera, she put up four additional cameras on her own. Mm-hmm. So that's how easy they are to install. Anybody can install these cameras. Any questions on the cameras?
Yeah. Are they motion sensors, or are they on all the time, or how does
they're
it
all the time.
They're on all, so all day long, 24 hours a day, they're taking pictures.
And they have great night vision. I can see in my front yard sometimes, I think, better at night than I can in the daytime.
So what do you do then? Like at the end of the day, do you erase it and start over if there's nothing there, or how do you leave?
Okay, so
what do you do, like at the end of the day, do you erase 24 hours?
No, DVR can be for 6 months, and then after that 6 months, it can override it, or I can delete it. And it depends, you know, if I go 6 months and my neighbor's down and complained about seeing a car or doing something, then I'll just let it up the light. And the other ones, they're on the internet. So I can go out, they'll capture all the events. I can go out and look at some specific event, or I can go out and just back up the camera as far as I want to back up.
When you say the other ones, you mean the Weiss ones?
Yeah. Yeah, Weiss and Night Owl.
How are you paying for monitoring charges? Because, like, we have Weiss and we have, I don't know, Rand, I think, but we're paying two separate bills every month.
On the Weiss, if you want to keep it, I think, for over 30 days, and it's $3 a month. On the Rand, it's like $1.99, right?
Ours is going to be $4 or $5.
But I just pay, and I can't say how much.
Okay, you
do. I don't know why I pay it, because it's really useless. I'm not happy with that. Because of the locations.
Yeah, we did have our plug into the wall. We just had them sitting on the ledge, the window ledge. We just put one on our patio and one on our front door, and we should use the whole neighborhood. We're not handy. So we just have it sitting there.
Yeah, I think that's really an advantage. If you can get a better view with the ring camera, my daughter has one up in Phoenix, and she gets a great view of the ring camera. Any other questions? Yes.
When you say yours is hardwired, that means you had to have wiring done in?
I have a cable that goes from my camera to the DVR. The DVR is plugged into electricity. And then I have a security monitor that my DVR is plugged into that. Because in the older days, it wouldn't work on anything other than a lone monitor. Today, Night Owl's come out with a new application. I can run it on my Mac now. So I could take the other monitor out. Kind of used to it now. Anything else? So security is important for us in our neighborhood. I had the chief of police here about a month ago. And he brought an entire list of incidents within Sunflower. So there are things that happen regularly, but like I said, those are my beautiful children. Most of us sleep in the back of our house. So if things happen out front, you normally don't hear or see those things. And unless somebody tells you about them, you really don't know that they even happened. Snowbirds, we have a great block captain on our street that
monitor. She's on the corner, so she can see all the way down the street. And so this camera, as you can see, goes from my house all the way down to the corner. So I can see everything that happens on that street. Then I have another camera on the other side over there, you can barely see there. And it goes all the way down the street to the other corner. So I can see the entire wildflower street. So if anything happens out there and I find out about it, I can usually pull it up and copy that video and give it to Miranda PD or whatever.
But it, will you share some of the nature of some of these incidents that I
noticed? Well, a lot of minor burglaries out of the yard, thefts out of the yard, pots, you know, that kind of stuff. Car theft, anytime there's a car outside. My son was in my driveway, got home at midnight, came in the house next morning about 7 o'clock. I got a call from the center. They found his wallet up near Linda Wire's house, actually. And we went up and picked up, it was laying in the cul-de-sac there. We picked all of his stuff up. The only thing that was missing was his debit card. By the time we got home and called the bank, they had done 5 car washes down on 22nd Street and bought 60 some dollars worth of sandwiches at the restaurant. So it doesn't take very long for it to happen, but you know, he left his car open, which he does all the time, and made it easy. So car theft is probably one of the number one things that happened.
Tom, have we had any catalytic converters stolen from cars?
I haven't heard of any. None. Most cars are in the garage, I think. Yeah, Joe, about.
When you said that you ran a cable into your DVR, is that from one of these camera units that all the other ones talked to, and then, or did you have to run every?
Every camera that I have has a cable going from the camera to the VCR.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not at the house open. It's usually that. I don't think we spent an hour and a half looking the whole system. That's pretty easy.
Yeah, that's a Nighthawk system, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the Y system doesn't use any wire other than the power.
And if you do solar, you don't need that,
right?
Do you need your internet to be working for the the Y camera?
Yes, you need Wi-Fi for that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, the other thing about Y is you can take those with you if you travel. You can take that Weiss camera, you can put an SD card in it, you can put it in your hotel room, you know, leave it there, and it'll capture the housekeeper going through your luggage.
Is the night owl the same kind of a thing as the Weiss?
No, it's more of a professional grade camera. It's a little higher cost, obviously. Anybody use Nest cameras? They were very expensive. It was $380 a piece. Very good quality, but they're good. So there are so many cameras like White today. There's a company called X10 that has inexpensive cameras. All of them work pretty well today. Any other questions? Anything about security that I couldn't think of that I could answer?
So, the Weiss camera, you're saying it's sitting on a table in your backyard?
I've got a.
Does that mean somebody could pick it up and take it away?
They could now, yeah.
Right.
I was just trying to catch that money rabbit.
Right.
But this is a camera right here. It's mounted. And I have another one on this side. I have one in my doorway.
So if they're mounted, they're secured by somebody walking away with them.
Yeah, it only takes one, they're really light and small. So I have like one screw that holds it there. And they stay there forever and ever. So I'm not had any problems with them.
Somebody walking by. It's very scary.
Yeah. I'll tell you, these neighbors, they'll just wander up and down the street.
Can you tell us a little bit more about the block wash? How is that working out? It's varied by its form.
Yeah, it's a good time because I've got to talk about this in about a week. Right now, we have 6 formal block captains. And with that, there's about 119 homes that participate formally. That means they have email addresses and I know it. But we have, I would guess, 15 more that are informal. In other words, how many of you live on a block that you watch your neighbor's houses that aren't block captains, you know? So we have a lot of that in our block up until just recently when we started the block up program again. I was kind of the block captain. I mean, I watched the streets. And I'm a cop. If somebody comes to my door peddling, I chase them off the street. Then Shelly moved in and she took them. I liked her a lot. It's a great program. You know, it's 40% of our community is snowbirds. So 40% of our people are gone every summer. And the problem that I get frustrated about are people campaigning and putting door hangers on or coming up and knocking on the door trying to peddle solar or whatever. I'm not thinking about what they're trying to sell or campaign for. I'm thinking about how they're identifying the houses that nobody's in. And now a couple of years ago, a lady stopped by the house and was campaigning for a judge. And I said, I can't believe you're hanging these things on doors in our neighborhood. Now, your judge isn't smart enough to figure out that he's identifying all the homes that nobody's in. I said, and the former officer of the law and him being a judge, why don't you tell him smart enough? But it just, that's the frustrating part. People identify homes too easily. Now, what we think our landscape, everybody has a white pickup truck to be a landscaper, right? So you can have those guys driving around your neighborhood who aren't really landscapers and identifying those houses that have door hangers hanging in. I actually followed a guy in my golf cart, got his license number, and he was a young kid, probably in his early 20s, long hair. And I called the Marana PD, and they caught him at the entryway, and he was a landscaper. Sorry. But yeah, I guess I'd rather be overcautious instead of be not cautious. That answer those questions? Mm-hmm. Anyone else?
Thank you. Do you have any recommendations for, like, to say we wanted to do something, but we don't want to mess with it. We just want to have somebody come out and set us and stuff. Do you have any commercial?
Jim, we'll see.
Ready to volunteer for anything.
You know, I've done it always myself, so.
So you don't have any commercial?
I'm sure there are people here that I've helped. Almost all my neighbors set the cameras up. Like I said, they're so easy.
Right.
Once you set one up, the rest of them are easy to go. Yes, it's good.
Comcast has cameras. They'll set up cameras.
Who?
Comcast.
Oh, will it?
I believe so. Yeah, they sell security systems, so yeah. Fairly well.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Somebody keeps borrowing my ladders to install again. So I know that.
Someone's going to have to borrow. It didn't happen after the swim. Put my hearing aids back in so I can hear.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
So remember to let us know if you got a tech talk to give us starting in October. We'd love to hear it. I see it. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Here, this team, yeah.